Hello and welcome at Christiani.biz, and thank you for your interest in the Cbiz ScrewIt rig. Let me give you a quick overview what you get when you download the file, or you downloaded it and you don't know what to do with it. Just quickly click on it and see the settings and also the materials that I threw in, four different materials. You can use them, you can delete them, or do whatever you want with them. For demonstration reasons, I'm gonna delete them all, which gives us a better view actually of the rig model or the rig itself. Quickly into the settings, the overall scale, well, explains itself and is by default set to 100%, because when we model into a one-to-one scale, those bolts get very small, or in the sense of here in centimeters, it's 1 centimeter long and has a diameter of 8 millimeters or 0.8 centimeters. But in the overall scale, if you have a bigger model and you need big bolts and big screws, whatever, you can crank it up. With this slider, it goes up to 1000%, which makes it already very big. But if you're modeling a ship, you can crank it up. I think 5000, I set the maximum. Anyway, let's go back to the default setting of 100%. Rotation, well, explains itself. You can turn it around in X and Y to place it where you need it. The head type, we have two different head types. We have the hexagon and the inverse, and in most cases this is what we need. We can set the height of the head, which is more important here in the hexagon, because you find different kind of hexagon bolts with different heights. Screw length, well, explains also itself. You can set the length. And you see, when I change the length, we have the washer, we have the bolt, and a tiny bit of thread that follows the setting of the length. The screw diameter, well, explains itself as well. And let's keep it at 0.8. We have the end offset, which offsets the washer. Again, the bolt and the little thread piece. So if you want to have a little bit sticking out the bolt at the end or whatever, and we also can separately move the little piece of thread that shows for details just at the end of the bolt, because this piece actually is most of the time hidden inside your model. Okay, but let's have a look at this, how we use this. For example, let's have prepared here a little something. It's just two boxes, actually. They need to be fixed together. And we have here same situation. We have our little rig here that I opened. And with these two boxes that I prepared, let's have a look inside. We have already a cloner in there. We have those two boxes and a little rectangle that I'll use for the cloner to put the screws into place for the holes. Right, okay. Then let's drag our little rig inside the cloner. Inside the cloner, we tell them we want to have this on the object mode, and there's already the rectangle is inside there because I tested it. So for demonstration reason, I will not run into problems. Okay, let's hide that little rectangle, we don't need to see. And our little rig is already in place. We have just to adjust the length. Oh, let's go step by step here. Let's say the overall scale, I want to have big bolts holding that thing together. And well, it adjusted the length already a bit, so I take the length and I can fix it so it just touches the end of the two boxes. And let's say the thread offset, I want to have it show a little bit more of the thread, like this. And the bold height is good. I want to have a little, let's make it small bolds and put the thread back into place here inside. And there you go. That's it. Your two plates are fixed together, and this was done in no time, and hopefully this rig comes in handy for you too.